textile mill used to run off a water wheel before the canal went dry. It started up again recently, and whatever the Hatters did to get it working has enraged the dead eels. They're fighting in the streets.
Are you too busy making dresses?
Come on, let's get this guy.
Somebody, get over here. Let's see what's inside you.
I'm gonna put your name on my arm when I kill you.
Somebody, give me a hand. That's what happens when you tangle with a dead.
Nice.
Come on, let's get this guy.
What? Lucky bastard got me.
Out of bullets.
Don't look at me. Fry Jerome's in the apartment up there.
I heard he wasn't cheap. Limit just a few.
Get caught out when the dead eels come again.
System.
What's the password?
I seem to have forgotten it.
Nice try, River Rat. Get lost.
I'm stymied. I'm not dragging it up.
Finished. They'll never believe who saved me.
Welcome to the Draper's Ward Salvage and Resale, or the Black Market if you'd prefer. It's Dowd, right? Recognized your face from the posters. Not that I'd ever say anything to anyone, believe me. I'd be happy to have you for a customer.
What are you selling?
Tell me what strikes your fancy.
When he asked for the money back, like he was going to start begging.
And Wakefield just looks at him, like he doesn't even understand what's happening.
Hilarious. I can't believe Lizzie held us back all these years. This is...
Who's that?
Remember that smoke?
Yeah. You found out what it was?
Rothwild's place. That was also the booms we heard. Blown apart. Burned.
Who are you? Are you with her?
With her?
Delilah. Are you with her? No, but you don't have any roses.
What can you tell me about Delilah?
I used to make clothing for the Caldwins, you see. I adored them, especially young, precocious Emily. She was such a delight. Did you ever meet the Empress? She was so special. And I was able to count her among my friends. I had a lock of hair from young Emily, a keepsake given to me by the family when my hands grew too stiff and clumsy to work the needle. I have treasured it so.
And Delilah?
She visited me here. Such a surprise to see her. All grown up. So serious. Did you know she was once a playmate of Jessamine's? Before she was Empress, when they were both little. I thought it was a cordial visit at first, but it turned frightening.
What happened?
She made things come out of the shadows, long and grasping. I can still feel the cold on my neck. I sound mad, don't I? Perhaps I am. She questioned me and left me propped in the corner like a bolt of cloth. I couldn't move for 3 nights while she made the horrid markings you see now. Then she stole my only keepsake, my lock of hair from dear, sweet Emily. Ah, Emily, where are you? Damn that Corvo, and damn Delilah.
Wakefield's a hard man, but he's not as fun as Lizzie. Lizzie enjoyed it more.
Yeah, even Lizzie never drowned victims in a sack. Still see him squirming for air.
Yeah.
Edgar Wakefield is on board the Undine. He's put all of the eels on alert since Lizzie's rumored to have escaped from Coldridge. He's expecting her. You will undoubtedly be a surprise to him.
There's the boat. Wakefield's probably keeping himself below decks. Whatever I do to him, it'll be a mercy compared to what Lizzie has in mind.
Just wait.
All those prams and nobles and fancy masks.
Wakefield sealed himself in the cargo hold of the Undine. Smuggling ships like this one often have a hatch underneath for dumping contraband if they get caught. Perhaps the Undine is no different.
Two butchers came here looking for work, crying about their warehouse.
You ever get that creepy feeling? Had that a bunch lately.
This is the Dowd I remember. Corvo left his mark on Coldridge, but they won't soon forget you either. What a relief. Life has been remarkably grim in Dunwall lately. This business with the eels might call for a little more diplomacy. But in the long view, a smoking ruin makes as good a monument as any.
Must have been rats.
Somebody get over here!
I see something, or someone, out of the corner of my eye. But when I turn, they're gone. Someone is watching us.
Lizzie's boat is smaller than I remember.
This would work.
Time to signal Lizzie. dies.
Lizzie Stride is assuming control of the Dead Eels now. She's ordered them to give you safe passage.
Your friend Edgar Wakefield set me up to be taken by the City Watch, and you followed him. Took his orders. But you know what? I forgive you. All of you. I'm filled with love. But the following people each owe me a finger. Logan, Douglas, Bang Bang, Ferris, Pigface, the Bakers, and Annabelle.
Shit.
Two from you, Annabelle. Have a good night.
That piece of garbage, Edgar. I'm still living with his incompetence. He let the Hatters cripple the Undine.
Ship seems fine to me.
They took the engine coil. We're dead in the water.
What is it? Can we make a new one?
They don't make them anymore. Not for an engine like the Undine's. We'll have to get it back.
The geezer still leads the Hatter gang, right? I'll pay him a visit.
It won't be that easy. There's a snag.
Always is. What's this one?
The geezer's about 100 years old by now. He's got it rigged so that if he dies, the whole place gets gassed. So they're real careful around him. Got him a nurse and everything. Maybe you can cut a deal for that engine coil. Turn on the charm. One of the Hatters gave me their door password in exchange for keeping the rest of his fingers. It's whalebone. I never got to use it on account of the gas. And being in jail.
Just be ready to move when I get back.
You really think the outsider ain't real? What'd I see Dowd do then?
Just because he can do strange things doesn't mean there's a...
Show his face. See what
all
I
these
do.
Rats crawling all over.
Are using the textile machines to make shrouds for the plague dead.
Now we know why they took the engine coil.
The man who runs the Hatters is more cunning than he looks. He can flood this place with a toxic gas. In time, it'll eat through our air filters. You may have to make a deal.
Don't mean the rest of us are idiots.
Yeah. Well, since you're set.
Sorry.
settled in over here.
Didn't think I'd ever see you again. After you helped us escape the slaughterhouse, I got a job here running the looms. They got us working around the clock, making shrouds for all of the plague victims. Kinda makes me sick. But they have to come from somewhere, I guess.
How do I get into the engine room?
It's down in the basement. But you can't get in without the combination.
And where would I find that?
Nurse Trimble. He takes care of the geezer. But I'd bet my broom handle that's only half the story. See, the geezer's supposed to be the boss, but Trimble never lets anyone near him. Claims it's for his health. I'm sure the geezer knows the combination too, except fat chance talking to him alone. Only time Nurse Trimble leaves is to check the lab equipment he's got upstairs.
Thanks for the help.
This guy.
Hey, dead body. Body. Wonder what got this guy. Someone.
Calculated badly.
sweet sight. Dowd, quick, come close. Look at the pickle I'm in. Word's out about your deal with Lizzie. I know why you're here. You want that engine coil? It's yours. You just have to do one thing, assassin. Kill me. This contraption, Trimble's machine, get it off me. Let me die. I'll give you what you want.
All I have to do is pull that oil tank?
No, not yet. Trimble's machine keeps me alive. But he's rigged it so that gas will flood the mill if I die. Insurance. Search Trimble's quarters. Upstairs, he has antitoxin he drinks every day, just in case I croak. You'll have to make some to survive the gas.
But everyone will die. Not just you.
These hatters. They're not my hatters, don't deserve the name. Trimble's been calling the shots for years. They can choke and die, every last one.
This guy never made it back. Wonder if he's still down there.
Lurk told me you wouldn't give up, even as she knelt before me and gave me all your secrets. I know what you're doing, Dowd. I know what that mark on your hand is. Just like the one on mine. I know everything you can do, and it won't matter. Four of us chosen, but history will only remember one. Delilah.
If they remember any of us.
Thank you.
knows you're coming, cutting a bloody path through the city in search of her. Your nastiest work in years. She's afraid of you. But Delilah's a brilliant woman. Her coven is rising, with her as the night star to guide them. And once she's hatched her new schemes, she'll have a different kind of power. An empire instead of a coven. I wish you luck. I don't decide who wins and whose body gets tossed in the river to rot. But I do enjoy watching.
Down. Fire up the engine from the bridge.